Esrom Abbey is a former Cistercian abbey founded in 1151 with monks from Clermont, France, and was destroyed in 1559. And it has been one of the largest abbeys here in Denmark and also one of the most significant.
Esrom Museum came to us with a dream of recreating the lost abbey so that visitors could experience what the abbey was like in its prime.
We have only one tenth left, so we have only a little bit of the puzzle.
When we first got the project pitched to us, it was huge. All these things that had to be rendered, and a very big building and a big world that had to be recreated from almost nothing.
So it's all about making inaccessible spaces and places accessible again.
In order to reconstruct Esrom Church in VR, first we had to gather up as much material as we could, which there wasn't that much of. The church doesn't exist anymore. There was a lot of back and forth between us and the historians to make sure that we got the details correct.
Virtual reality is super interesting for the museum sector because we can recreate what's lost to us and we can bring back to life our cultural heritage and our history.
And this requires a lot of attention to detail. You want those surfaces to look just right for the camera.
And I think they have been really, really great catching the feeling of the abbey and the texture and the light. They have been awesome.
So virtual reality gives us a magical ability to transport audiences and people across time and space.
It was really a big experience to see this is our abbey rising in front of our eyes, because we always just had this one building.
And that really hit home, because that's all we could want as creators, to see that amazement and give that to them to experience.
It's really important to have this experience for our visitors, because it's so abstract when we tell the story. And to finally, for the first time since 1559, to show people how it has probably been. It's a huge thing that we can show our guests.
Virtual reality is the closest that we have to a time machine, and therefore, moving forward and in the future, I think we're going to see every single museum making use of this technology.